Ladies and gentlemen, welcome on board of this flightacademy.info masterclass. My name is Luis Comendador, and we are about to start a new video. Sit back, relax, and learn. What is the difference between heading and track? The definition of heading is the compass direction in which the longitudinal axis of an aircraft points. The definition of track, or course, is the projection on the Earth's surface of the path along which an airplane has flown. So, the answer of this question is: heading is referred from the longitudinal axis of a plane, and the track is referred to the path over the ground, which the plane is overflying. When the wind is calm, the plane we'll have the same heading and the same track, but in the situation where we have lateral wind, the heading and the track are different. The Earth is a big magnet, and every magnet has a north and a south pole. The compass, which is the instrument that we have in the plane, always points to the north pole. The magnetic north changes with the time. In 1984, it was in Canada, and now it is close to Russia. The true north is a fixed point on the Earth, where is the origin of the meridians. The angle between the heading and the true north, it is called true heading. The angle between the track or course and the true north is called true track or true course. The angle between the heading and the magnetic north, it is called magnetic heading. The angle between the track or course and the magnetic north is called magnetic track or magnetic course. To standardize the way we navigate, we have made maps based in the true north, because it never changes. And as we cannot know where is pointing the longitudinal axis of the plane this particular day, we use the track that is following. To conclude, from the maps, we get the true track. However, the instrumentation of our plane gives us the magnetic heading. How does a pilot calculate the magnetic heading? First, the pilot finds out the true track from the chart using the plotter. Second, this chart has the declination, which is the difference in degrees between the true north and the magnetic north. Third, we figure out the wind predictions. With these predictions and the flight computer, we calculate the drift. The drift is the amount of degrees the wind is pushing us. In other words, the difference between heading and track. Fourth, at this point, we would have been able to calculate the magnetic heading. Then, we have to check the specific error of our compass to calculate the compass heading. Until here, the video of today. Do you have a specific navigation, ATPL or PPL question? Just write it in the comments and I will solve it. Thank you for choosing flightacademy.info. We are happy to see you again.